a very warm and heartily welcome to Beth B, director of Exposed, an amazing documentary about the alternative burlesque scene of New York City, the contemporary burlesque scene of New York City. And before we get deeper into the topic, I would like to ask you how you came across the topic and how you decided to make this very beautiful, stunning documentary.
Well, I was actually working in television.
Okay.
I was producing and directing documentaries for television, and after about 8 years of that, my soul had been sucked out of me, and I felt like I really needed to go back to my roots.
Mm-hmm.
And my roots are really in the underground of New York City,
mm-hmm.
the subculture.
Mm-hmm.
That's where I come from. And so I started kind of searching. I had Jeff Solomon was working for me at the time, and he brought me to my first show. And it took me a while, though, to find. I knew there was something there that really spoke to me.
Mm-hmm.
But it took me a while to find my characters,
mm-hmm.
because I did not want the pretty girl
mm-hmm.
with the cute little body, you know, mm-hmm. the normal. I didn't
mm-hmm.
want the normal.
At the age of 15, I left home, and I was raised by a pack of drag queens and hairdressers. It really provided me with a super safe and supportive environment to explore how I wanted to express myself, my sexuality. It really just gave me a safe cushion from the rest of the world.
I walked down this tiny block called Garden Street, and all of a sudden, there was the land of milk, glitter, and honey. There was shoulder-to-shoulder faggot in black velvet cloaked capes with skull buckle boots made out of patent leather hugging their ankles, flaring into pointy tips. Cloves, cigarettes, Aquanet, and vodka filled the air. It was the 80s, honey, and I had arrived. I could not believe it.
By the time I was about 16, I actually identified as a gay male. I decided I wanted to be a drag queen. I couldn't stop thinking about it. And I would draw in books all these characters and their names, and Barbarella, the space goddess, and Ragabob, the rag doll. The desire to express myself in this over-the-top feminine way didn't cease. It just kept growing and growing and growing, to the point where I did believe that I had to be a man to be a drag queen.
Movie quiet. Thank you, movie.
I started flirting with the idea of becoming a transsexual. Of having a sex change so I could be a real gay guy, you know? And then I would dress up like a woman, which sounds like a Rubik's Cube with all the stickers torn off, but that was just my reality. I made a list of how you could tell a man in drag was a man. The street term for that is spooking, like, oh, you can spook her beard, referring to seeing the stubble coming through makeup. Or the Adam's apple, you know? She was doing great, but I spooked her apple. So what I did was I covered up my hands. I always wear gloves. I covered my throat like I had an Adam's apple. I used concealer that was theatrical grade to cover up my 21-year-old skin that didn't have a hair on it, but it looked like I was covering a beard. During the day, I wore men's underwear. I dressed very androgynously. I did not look like a guy, and I did not look like a girl. I looked like somebody in between. I told my friends, I'm gonna move to New York City now and be a transsexual, meaning a woman. But a lot of people might be confused and think, you were already a woman, there was no change for you. I performed in the nightclubs, and I became very affected and influenced by the transsexual community. And this is the table where I felt I had a place where I could breathe, like the only place. And I would do anything to be allowed to stay there.
No.
But what attracts you about burlesque? What is it?
It wasn't so much burlesque.
It was really
the individuals that I met and the individuals that I cast in the film, because they were doing something that is beyond burlesque.
Mm-hmm.
I feel like what they're doing is performance art. They're using the tropes of burlesque, but mm-hmm. they're really talking about difficult issues. You know, things about identity, about gender, about, you know, political issues, social issues.